Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Naseem Gul, your linguistic teacher. Today we are taking second lecture, that's about types of meaning. And we have defined in earlier lecture, in our first lecture, that what is semantic and what's the purpose of semantics. So now we are semantics is the study of meaning of words, phrases and sentences. Now we have different types of meanings. First distinction between meaning is conceptual and associative meaning. Now, what is conceptual meaning? Conceptual meaning covers those basic essential components of meaning that are conveyed by the literal use of a word. Like we have literal meaning of words, istilahi meaning of word, lughavi meaning of words. We have two types of meanings, literal meaning of words, and these literal meaning of words are called the dictionary meaning of words, and we have associative meaning of words. Dictionary meaning of words means lughvi meaning of words, those meanings which are recorded or written in dictionaries, on which dictionaries are designed for the explanation of words, for the meaning of words. So conceptual meaning, the first type, the first distinction we are making in meaning of words, conceptual meaning and associative meaning. Now I am explaining conceptual meaning. Conceptual meaning are the literal meaning of words, like the components of a word. Needle might include thin, sharp, steel instrument. These are the conceptual meaning of the word needle. This is something thin, something sharp, and something which is made of steel. It's called steel instrument. For example, the word strange, we have different, like we have 26 conceptual meaning of a word strange, like unusual. This is the literal meaning of the word strange. And uncanny, array, weird, difficult, surprising, mysterious, enigmatic, odd, unfamiliar, peculiar, unknown, foreign. So these all are unclear, alien, unnatural, curious, obscure. These all are the literal meaning of a word strange. Another example, laughter and its types. Like we have chuckle, it's a synonym for word laughter. Giggle, titter, chortle, cackle, the belly laugh. Remember students, there is some differences are there, like laughing. We have different types of laughing or laughter. We have the intensity of laughing. It's about the intensity, the frequency of laughing. So chuckle or giggle, giggling, tatter, chortle, cackle, the belly laugh. So these all are different according to the frequency or intensity of laughing. So these all are related. These all are the literal meaning of a word laughter. So when we are learning a word, first we are checking, we are referring to dictionary, that what is the literal meaning of that very word in which we are interested. Find the literal meaning for the word for the following word by your own, anger or angry. It's your task, dear students. You should find the literal meaning, a list of literal meaning for a word, anger or angry. It's your task. You should later on send me conceptual meanings. Now, conceptual meanings are the literal meaning of words, the basic meaning of words, the primary meaning of words, the dictionary meaning of words. These are also called denotative meaning of words, like denotative denotative means the dictionary meaning. D stands for dictionary. Now, the second type of meaning in first distinction, that is associative meaning. We are making association among things for the sake of understanding. We understand one thing with the help of another thing. So this connection, this association is called a relation. This association is called in meaning. While explaining meaning, this association is called associative meaning of words. Like we understand one word with the help of another word. We explain one concept with the help of another concept. So we associate one concept with another concept for the sake of understanding, to understand that very concept. So we need association. We need connection. But remember, this connection, this association is very difficult for beginner. For beginner students, a student of initial classes, like school students, they can't make enough association, enough connection. But at degree level, at at BS level, at MPhil or PhD level, scholars, they can make connection, they can make association, they can they have improved vocabulary, they have very range, they have very high frequency of words. So that's why they can make connection, they can make association. So this association is very difficult, but with the help of conceptual meaning, with the help of literal meaning, we can make later on, we can make association, associative meanings are understood by us. For example, now we have discussed that the literal meaning of a word needle according to dictionary is pain. According to dictionary, it's also illness, related to illness. Okay, now some people, they are making association with the word needle, pain. Literal meaning is different, like steel instrument, like it was a steel instrument we have discussed, but now it's association with pain, with illness, with blood, with drugs, with thread or knitting. Or some people associate with hard to find, like needle is something which is hard to find. Okay, these associations, yes, it's very important. Please note it down. It's very important. These association, like the word needle association with pain, with illness, with blood, etc. These associations vary from person to person, from context to context. These associations are not fixed. These associations are not restricted. These associations are different. Okay? These associations vary from context to context in which they are used, in which we are using words. So, like in Pakistan, like in Pakistani context, here in KPK, here at CUST, or at our college, we have different association with words. But in other province or in other countries even, people have different association with different words. So that's why it's also a difficulty to understand words to understand the associative meaning of words. It requires, okay, enough study, enough experience is required, enough knowledge is required to understand associative meaning of words, because these words, these meanings are not fixed. Now, associative meanings are used by whom? Who are using these associative meaning of words? Poets, they are using in poetry. They are making association. They are making a connection. Like while they are explaining, they are describing their beloved. Okay, so then they are using associative meanings. They are using association. Okay, association. They are using words basically, but in these words, they are making connections. They are making association while describing their beloved ones. So, the use, like poetry is the language which is based on associative meaning of words. We are not taking always the literal meaning of words. If we are taking the literal meaning of words, then there will be no beauty of poetry. Okay, we love poetry, we understand, we appreciate poetry, we sing poetry. Okay, so why we sing poetry, why we have interest in poetry? Because of association. Though we are interested in the association, in the connection which are built by, which are made by the poets, okay, while describing their beloved. So songs writers, they are also, yes, songs writers, even they are poet. Novelists, yes, novelists, they also use in their novels, while writing novels, they are using associative meaning of words. Critics, yes. Advisors, advertisers, politicians, lovers, yes, it's very important. Lovers, they also, like when they are when they are making connection of their beloved, like when they are describing the lips of their beloved, they are saying, my beloved lips are red rose. Okay, TV anchors, they are also making association, they are also using, they are also taking help from associative meaning of words. Now, the main concern of linguistic semantics is to analyze the conceptual meaning. The first one, okay, the first type of meaning, which is conceptual meaning. The main concern, the main job of linguistic semantic is conceptual meaning. So the main job of linguistic semantic is to analyze the conceptual meaning, the literal meaning, the basic meaning, the primary meaning of words. So now, what is the definition of associative meanings? Associating meanings are the connotative meanings. Connotative means to suggest, okay? Connotate, connote, C-O-N-N-O-T-E. The secondary meaning, the implicit meaning, or the hidden meaning, suggestive meaning, or applied meaning, okay? Now, like for example, in newspaper, okay, it's Dawn newspaper, justice for Justice Isa. Now, two words are there, same word, but different association. Justice and justice for Justice Isa. Now, the first one is different from the second one. Same word is used, but different association, different meanings are there. So words having different meanings at different level. Dear students, any question please, you can ask me, you can comment. Okay, yes, so thank you for listening, for understanding. Thanks a lot.